Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to quickly create a stunning photographic double exposure portrait. Open a photo of someone you'd like to use for this project. If you want to crop your photo, open your rectangular marquee tool and drag it over your subject. Go to Image and Crop. To deselect it, press Ctrl or Command D. To fit your photo back onto your canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0. Next, we'll create a selection around your subject in order to separate it from its background. There are many ways to do this, and I cover them in many of my tutorials. Since this photo has a white background, I'll use the magic wand tool. If you're using this tool as well, check contiguous and make its tolerance approximately 30. Click on a white area outside your subject to make a selection of that area. Go to another white area and shift-click on it to add that selection as well. To check your selection, press Q to see it as a quick mask. If you're happy with it, press Q again to revert it back into a selection. Then invert the selection by pressing Ctrl or Command Shift I. Click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection. Ctrl-click or Command-click on the new layer icon to make a new layer below the active layer. We'll fill the empty layer with white, but first, if your foreground and background colors aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Since white is your background color, press Ctrl or Command plus Delete. Click the thumbnail of your subject to make it active, and click the adjustment layer icon. Click Black White. Open the preset flyout list and click High Contrast Blue Filter. Click back on the adjustment layer icon and this time click Levels. In the Input White field, I'll type in 142. Drag the Levels adjustment layer below the black and white layer. Make the white layer active. Open your other photo that we'll use to create the double exposure. To place it into your subject's document, press Ctrl or Command A to select it all, and Ctrl or Command C to copy it. Open your other document, and press Ctrl or Command V to paste it in. Drag your subject's layer mask next to the other photo. Make your subject active and change its blend mode to overlay. If you want to reposition the image inside your subject, click off the chain link icon. This unlinks the photo and the layer mask, which allows us to resize and reposition the layer and the layer mask independently of each other. Make the photo active and open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. If your photo is larger than your subject, press Ctrl or Command 0 to see the Transform's entire bounding box. To reposition it, go inside the Transform and drag it. To resize your inside image, go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Shift as you drag the transform in or out. To accept it, click the check mark at the top. Then, fit your document back onto your canvas. If you want to lighten some dark areas, invert your foreground and background colors by clicking this icon or by pressing X on your keyboard. Open your Dodge tool and click Shadows for the range. the exposure is 100%, and make sure Protect Tones is checked. Open the brush picker. We'll take care of the size in a moment. Make the hardness 0% and press Enter or Return. To make your dodge tool smaller or bigger, press the left or right bracket key on your keyboard. Brush over the dark areas you'd like to lighten. Conversely, if you want to darken some light areas, invert your colors, and open your burn tool. This time, click Midtones or Highlights. I'll reduce the exposure to 25% and brush over those areas. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.